That one definitely got a little bit squirrely, but you know what? The end result is still the same. Avs win over the New York Islanders 7-4. This was the first game this season where the Avs fully blew a lead and then were trailing in the game. Now, they obviously pulled it out in the end, but there was some sketchiness to this one. And I say that understanding the San Jose game, which they trailed for most of, but they have been really good with leads so far this season. This one got a little dicey. It did not start that way, though. The Avs played a fantastic first period, starting by getting on the power play early and converting. Honestly, I think this play might sum up the whole game for the Avs. Squirrely, but effective. The Isles deep in the Avs zone at the start of an Avs power play. A turned over puck comes to Makar. He doesn't really control it well, but he just kind of does enough to make it work, to create a 3-on-1 opportunity for the Avs. Mikko just built different. Doesn't matter that he's on his backhand side. Doesn't matter. At all. A lot of people walk in and shoot this. Mikko is going to backhand sauce it over to a wide open Raijo, and the pass is so good, Raijo doesn't even get a ton of this, but it still gets in the net. The Avs were abusing passes across the middle of the ice all game long. They really could have blown this team out in the first period with a bit better finishing. This game easily could have been 4-1. Both Nathan MacKinnon and Ross Colton had wide open nets to shoot at that they just did not put a good enough shot on, either shooting it back into Sorokin or missing the net entirely. If those go in, was probably another easy win for Colorado. Makar also hit a post later in the game, so that is bad post number 6 of the season for the Avs. And despite a quality first period where the Avs outshot the Islanders 17-6, there is still that effect of hockey. All it takes is one play for a puck to go in. It's a dumped in puck from the Isles that rims around and goes back to Georgiev. A little bit of miscommunication here. Georgiev kind of whips this thing too hard along the boards up in the air. And because of that, Makar mishandles it. We'd still like to see Makar control it and get it out here, but it ends up being a turnover. And the Avs are a little bit discombobulated. No one covering high in the zone. It's not great, but it's really not terrible. The shot you're giving up here isn't all that dangerous. The problem is the Avs also get beat crashing to the net. Nuke just kind of gets slipped in behind by Clutterbuck here, and he puts a great tip on a puck. Credit there. As you'll see in the rest of these Islander highlights, the Avs were struggling at times to get the puck out of their own zone, just playing a little bit too fast and loose with it through most of the game. Overall, they haven't done a ton of that so far this season, but something you gotta clean up and something that will cost you games in the future if you continue to do it at the rate that they did tonight. It being Makar's mistake that led to the Isles' goal, he decides to go ahead and make up for it. This puck is gonna slip by Makar and out to the neutral zone where Makar is going to collect, and then the magic is going to happen. He's at the red line, he turns up the middle of the ice, recognizes a ton of things going on here. First of all, Isles trying to get a cheap change, so he has space to work with. Secondly, as he's approaching this blue line, look at him pull this puck back, hold it, wait for Mikko to get back onside, and then on top of that, he also uses a trick he learned from a couple of years ago, where if the puck is crossing the blue line, as long as he's not touching it, this is going to work out and be okay. So he can cross it. It's awfully close with Mikko with him crossing it, but he makes sure not to put his stick on the puck, so you get that tag up, and now he's good to go. Walks into the zone, cuts to his backhand side. Honestly, this is fine defense. This backhand is just not from this planet. Be honest, have you ever seen a defenseman with a backhand that good? If the answer is yes, please put him down in the comments because I would love to see it. Makar simply continues to do things that other people just don't or can't. Every single night, you're going to see something special from him. So it's a great first period, but it transitions into a sloppy second. The Avs have been getting away with a lot of penalties this year because of great penalty killing. Seems like the penalty killing might be starting to normalize now. The Isles get back into the game with a power play goal of their own. Isles power play here, they're working the puck down in deep a lot, and because they stretch the ice, go deep to high a number of times, you see the Avs start to get pretty stretched out. Their second defenseman playing pretty up high in the zone. We've seen this before this year, where it leaves the deep man to cover two guys. It's just an impossible job, so Kale really needs to absolutely make sure he's in communication with Taves. If Taves is taking the guy in the middle, this is the passing lane that Cale Makar has to be denying, and he's just not doing that. That leads to a problem of a guy wide open in front of your net, and the puck goes in because of that. The Avs play defense a certain way, where they prefer to play higher in the zone and intercept pucks that are coming down to the players down low instead of bodying up those players net front often. I'm not saying that's the wrong way to play, but when the Avs fail to intercept those passes, when their defense isn't clicking, it becomes very obvious that big hole in front of the net. The Isles did a good job of abusing that in this game, both on the power play and at 5-on-5. And from there, you have the Avs' first fully blown lead of the season, with another Isles goal a few minutes later. It's a 2-on-2 rush here for the Isles. It's not great, but it shouldn't be all that dangerous on the initial attempt, and it really isn't, as Georgiev knocks a puck to the outside. The Avs are back. This should be an easy backcheck. At worst, you have a puck battle along the boards. But Nuke gets greedy here. He just goes for a quick stick lift, tries to win that puck from the far side of it and get up the ice quick, and the Avs are cheating, both MacKinnon and Rantanen casually turning up the ice, thinking they're about to get an easy breakout. That's not what happens. The stick lift doesn't work, Val loses the battle, and now all three Avalanche forwards are behind the play and chasing. That leaves enough room for the puck to get to the middle of the ice and for Georgiev to get beat. Honestly, that felt to me like a team that may have been a little bit overconfident. Them expecting to win the puck battles not because of effort, but because they were just the better team. And they paid the price for that right there. From that goal over the next 5 or so minutes was probably some of the worst hockey I've seen the Avs play this season. It was just really sketchy. The Avs seemed to lack a lot of confidence. Nothing was really working. They were chasing the play a ton, and what's more, it seemed like they were kind of feeling the pressure. It seemed like they were gripping the sticks and making simple errors that they really shouldn't be making. And credit to the Islanders, they were pushing back strong too. There is another team out on the ice. But importantly, the Avs survived that stretch of time. They didn't give up that next goal to go down two. And a one-goal game can get flipped on its head very, very quickly. Less than a minute to go in the second period, a 13-second span completely changes the game. This looks a lot more like Avalanche hockey. Kale with a perfect breakout up the ice to Beau, who gets it ahead to Nuke. Nuke gets in the zone deep, and the Avs have the Isles chasing a bit. They cut down in a little bit deep. They have to respect Mikko. They have to respect MacKinnon, who's going to cut to the middle of the net. But it discombobulates New York a little bit. Because of MacKinnon cutting down, you have multiple players turning, worrying about MacKinnon. And all of a sudden, all of this space opens up for Bowen Byram. And he uses it perfectly. He steps into it. He gets a lot of it. He finds a shooting lane. And he lets one rip. It's a great shot. And it finds its target. The Avs won the immediate faceoff ensuing after Byram's goal, and this is a pretty simple start. Manson's just going to dump this puck in hard, allows the Avs to get in and chase, and one miscue from the Isles, and they're on top of you. Val is right there to take the puck away. Honestly, I'm not sure how much of this was totally on purpose. I think Val kind of just YOLO'd that pass out to the middle, but he gets it to open space, and here is a MacKinnon that is about to cut in, find this puck, and be a really good hockey player. First of all, great to see Beau starting to get going on offense a little bit. I know it's been a bit of a rocky start for him this year. There's still a really good hockey player in there. Secondly, Nathan MacKinnon is still Nathan MacKinnon. Really don't think he played particularly well in this game, but doesn't matter. It takes one shift for a guy like that to change a hockey game. And third, both of those goals are assisted by Val Nichushkin, the guy who arguably made the biggest mistake on New York's third goal. He steps up, makes up for his mistakes, and continues to be a linchpin for the Avs' top six. So, you don't love the path the Avs took to get there, but they're still up one after two. It wasn't going to get easier, though. The Avs were their own worst enemy at a lot of times in this game. New York deep in the Avs' zone, a lot of miscues from Colorado here. That's a flubbed puck coming to Manson. This should be out of the zone, automatic. Look at the situation. You're late, you're early in the third period, but you still have a lead in a third period. Don't take any unnecessary risks. Manson doesn't do that. He just kind of flubs this puck. It doesn't work out super well, but the Avs stay on it. A little bit of chaos created by bodies running into each other, but Ryan Johansson has this puck here. This puck is out. It needs to be out. It's a little flip. Nothing difficult about getting this puck out of the zone. He just makes a bad decision to hold on to this puck, try and cut back with it, except for he forgets the puck. That's a problem. Just unnecessary added problems that you didn't have to make for yourself if you're Colorado. This play never happens if Rijo just flips that puck out of the zone. From there, just a puck that comes through the high slot, not even the high slot, it's beyond the circles, really. This is not that dangerous of a shot. Georgiev really needs to save this one, but he doesn't. Yes, that turnover from Rijo is very, very bad, but you need a save. And this isn't some overarching thing. Georgiev will be fine. I still stand by what I said earlier, that I believe Georgiev will become the Avs' second best goalie ever. some nights it's just not going. He certainly made the Avs' job a whole lot harder tonight. Luckily, the Avs have one of the top 10 goal scorers in the NHL. Faceoffs only matter when they matter, and sometimes they kind of just don't matter, because the Avs are going to lose this one pretty clean as this comes back to Pellick on the blue line, but Tatar doesn't care. He's YOLOing in, going all in for this puck. He blocks the shot, it kicks out for him, and he's going to be the first man to it. From here, that's great work from Tatar right there. Oof, bright screen, rough. He's able to get to a puck and just throw it to space. He's not trying to create anything ridiculous here, but he gives the Avs an opportunity, and oh, look at that, it's Mikko Rantanen streaking across the other side of the ice about to beat your goaltender. That one would be your game winner, and it comes from the usual suspects. A power play goal from Johansson, by the way, has kind of seemed to figure things out. Things are starting to click for him in Colorado, particularly on special teams. Really encouraged by that. Your defense coming through for you, Cale Makar as usual, and Bowen Byram getting in on the action. Your superstars in Nathan MacKinnon and Mikko Rantanen picking up goals. And then Val Nichushkin and Tomas Tatar as auxiliary top six guys coming through, filtering in assists. And the Avs are able to close out this third period well. Yes, it wasn't as dominant as some of the close third periods of previous games, but it was still pretty darn good, honestly. New York's good chances get fended off, you get down to goalie pull time, and the Avs add two empty netters to the list. Rijo gets rewarded with a multi-goal game, and Ross Colton gets a bit of a silly one, but he gets his first in an Avs uniform. I'm not going to get to do 82 reviews of Avalanche wins. There's going to be some losses in there, but I'm not taking 60 off the table. The Avs might be that good. That is the end of this game video review. Thank you for watching. Head on over to thednvr.com for all of our coverage. I am Rudo, and 6 games into the season, the Avs already have 2 touchdowns.